Four members of each team. So there might be the white team and the black team, for example. The pack will take off. All eight skaters will take off, and a few seconds later, the ref blows the whistle for the jammers. There's one jammer from each team. There's, for example, a white team jammer and a black team jammer. Their goal is to skate through the pack. The first pass through the pack, you earn no points. It's always the second and other passes. For each member of the opposing team that they pass, they earn 1 point. So if, say, the jammer for the black team gets through the pack first and she doesn't make any fouls, she doesn't get any penalties for passing outside the track, then she's lead jammer.
She has the ability to call out the jam at any time, possibly stopping the other team from scoring. After that, they race around the rink as fast as they can, and every time the jammers come up to the back of the pack, everybody in the pack is trying to knock them down, and they are trying to fight their way through. Every woman they pass legally on the other team is a point. Then the jam is over either when the lead jammer calls it off or when 2 minutes have elapsed.
If you pass the other jammer, say you lap them, then you get an extra point. That's called a grand slam, and those are fun. There are three periods. They're 20 minutes per period, and then there's a break between each period of 10 to 15 minutes. And they count the points for every jam, and at the end of the game, whoever has the most points wins the game.
Sweet Mama and I have been best friends since we were 12. We went to South by Southwest in Austin, Texas, and we met their Derby League there, and we were in the car for a long time, and I decided that when I come back to Louisville, I'm gonna start a league. I'm married to it, I love it. It's amazing, it's fun.
A lot of times, roller derby embraces sort of pin-up image.
I like knocking girls down.
I really like camaraderie. The sport itself, though, mainly, I'd say playing, strategy, you know, dealing with aspects of the game. And
the phenomenal women that I've met.
Individuality and the opportunity that we get, even though we may be unified as a team and wear a similar uniform, we can sort of express our own personality and decorate our uniform how we like, have different helmet designs, have different skates.
Fulfilling the commitment, playing, coming, seeing my sisters, getting active, being competitive, meeting other people in other cities, getting press, being interviewed, all of those things. I like those things.
So many of these girls are professionals. What happens here doesn't leave here. You know, the girls are allowed to let out a bunch of anger and aggression, and they still, like, leave as best friends. I'm 29, and it's the first time I've ever been competitive, and I didn't know that I had it in me to actually play or knock girls around and exercise.
With the Derby City Roller Girls, you actually have to go through an 8-week training boot camp. You go through all the skills, whips, and how to take a hit, how to skate properly with the track. There are certain physics with the track that you need to use. How to skate with other girls, because it's actually pretty hard skating skate to skate, shoulder to shoulder, and get hit. After you complete your 8 weeks of training, which is 2 practices a week, then you actually get to graduate, and you get to start scrimmaging, and then play with the roller derby girls.
I think every woman should give it a shot. It's incredible because we have women of all ages and sizes, girls that are athletes and some that are not.
This is a sport and a league that's really taken off. You guys really ought to come check us out.
DCRG!
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 DCRG!